Welcome back. You're still watching Arise 360. Now, as always, it's been a busy day for the big screen and most especially the small screen, and we at Arise 360, because we're really good people, guys. We like to give you a helping hand with keeping track of what's been happening.
So how about we do this? Take a closer look at film and television. And of course, filling us in on all of the film and TV news, I am now joined by Arise Entertainment correspondent Afua Adam, live from our studios in London. Hi, Afua. Thank you so much for joining us on the show. So let's get the party started. Now, we have to enter the sequel territory to begin with. Exactly this time, it's with another outing for Angelina Jolie as Maleficent. I love that movie. Tell us about that.
Yes, of course. So we're talking about Maleficent 2. Of course, Angelina Jolie played the lead character in Maleficent in 2014, I think it was now, quite a while ago. Now, Maleficent 2 has been pulled forward. Its release date was supposed to be in 2020, and it's now going to be October 18th, 2019. It's in such high demand. So Angelina Jolie is going to be back in the title character. I'm so excited for that. Now, as I said, it was released in 2014. It was made with a budget of $180 million, but took over $750 million at box office, almost four times the figure invested. So it was a no-brainer that it was going to get a sequel. So Michelle Pfeiffer is going to join the cast as Queen Ingress. Chiwetel Ejiofor has been cast as well, rumored to be a potential love interest for Angelina Jolie's character. And Elle Fanning returns as Princess Aurora, of course, the young royal who was cursed by Maleficent to prick her finger and fall into a magic slumber, only to be awakened by true love's kiss. Prince Philip is back, of course, but this time he's going to be played by Cleek's Harris Dickinson, replacing Brenton Thwaites for this film. So Maleficent is going to be out October 18th this year, and we absolutely cannot wait. And of course, it is titled Disney's Maleficent, Mistress of Evil. So she's back to do some more evil. Angelina Jolie is always brilliant in this part. It's like it was made for her. She's amazing in it. So yes, I cannot wait for this one, October.
I absolutely love that. Maleficent, the mistress of evil. Isn't that interesting? Mm-hmm. But you know what? In all that you said, the only thing I heard was Chiwetel Ejiofor. Why? Because Nigerians winning, winning,
exactly.
winning.
But I do have to ask, you know, Afua, looking at the story behind Maleficent, we true love's first him. Kiss, usually Disney will let you know that, look, a prince has to be the one to give you that first kiss. So do you think maybe looking at how much they changed the narrative at the with the first movie, what can we expect from the second? Are we expecting another bombshell, something that is set to change the status quo as we know it?
Well, at the end of Maleficent, we saw Maleficent herself retreat and back down, and it was sort of like this happy ever after, isn't it? And I love the fact that we love to disrupt Disney's happy ever after. I'm so impressed by that. Now, Chiwetel's been brought in as a potential love interest for Maleficent, so could this soften her up? I'm really not sure, because she has been dubbed Mistress of Evil in this one, which is, you know, that's quite a title. So I think we can expect much more evil doings from Maleficent, and much more. I think it's probably going to be a sequel story about how Elle Fanning, her character Princess Aurora, is going on with her life, you know, reunited with her parents and all that good stuff. But I think potentially something to do with her love interest, somebody's trying to take that away from her. You know, she gets very, very jealous, does Angelina and Maleficent together. That's why they work. So I think what we can expect, I mean, it's titled Mistress of Evil. There's going to be a lot of evil in there, but I'm really interested to see Chiwetel's character in this, because it's not really him. You know, he's quite good in indie films, and of course he directed and is in The Boy Who Harnessed the Wind, which is doing really good streams on Netflix at the moment. So I'll be interested to see him in this kind of Disney universe.
Okay, now, Afua, let's change tack a little. Afua, we're going to change tack a little bit and talk about something that is quite marvellous. Now, as we all know, the brand new Captain Marvel film is out soon, and two of its stars have teamed up for a bit of karaoke. Now, Afua, I don't know about you, but I am a karaoke queen, baby. Give it a mic, let's go. What are we talking about?
Do you know what? I'm not a karaoke queen. I have my moments, but I would love to do karaoke carpool. It just looks like the funnest thing ever. So we've got two characters from Captain Marvel, Brie Larson and Samuel L. Jackson, have teamed up for James Corden's Carpool Karaoke. They're going to be in it, an upcoming episode that he teased. It just looks amazing. So they sing Seven Rings by Ariana Grande. I'm so here for that. But Samuel L. Jackson, because he's a bit cheeky, he brings in a lie detector and basically makes Brie Larson answer all these questions about Captain Marvel. Would she be honest with him if she didn't like him in a scene? She lies about liking his Kangol hats, don't we all? Because, I mean, they're terrible, but it's Samuel L. Jackson and we just let him away with it. And she also lies about him having a good singing voice. Bless him, he tried. He's not a triple threat, he's just an actor.
You know what? I've actually
Jackson, however,
him.
Did do the lie detector himself. Yeah, we have to,
no,
right?
We've forgiven
he's
him
such
now.
A legend.
I wasn't his friend
he doesn't
before,
doesn't lie detector
though.
Himself. she does the lie detector herself, and he said that he would be honest if he didn't like her performance in a scene, and he also answered a question, which was that he did fart on set.
Ooh, he did.
Well,
okay.
I'm sure they would have turned that into some type of sound effect or something that would make it sound, you know, normal and reasonable.
Well, I think that's a little bit better than what he was doing before, because I don't know if you remember, Afio, a few months ago when he actually went on radio and said that, you know what, British actors are a bit more low class than American actors, mm-hmm. and he was just upset because us British actors are going to Hollywood and stealing all the roles. So I wasn't his friend. I really wasn't his friend because I think like that.
True.
He should know better. He upset himself. He was talking about racism in the UK and how mm-hmm. we don't really understand the nuance, which is technically not true. But the point is, we've forgiven him. He's cool again.
Now,
he's
talking cool again. About, you know, upsetting people and being really, really upset about certain situations, we have to, once again, take another different route. Let's get into television now and talk about Arrow. Now, I'm sure Arrow fans are about to receive a huge blow. Now, we just need to know once and for all to get it over with. Is the series really over?
Unfortunately, it is done. It's even going to be a shorter finale season. So season 8 of Arrow is going to be the last one. It's going to be 10 episodes. And then the original show that spawned this whole Arrowverse is unfortunately done. Arrow fans are gutted. They've been reacting on social media to this one. And it's been a bit of a shock. I think people were not expecting it. But the lead actor in Arrow, Samuel Amell, he tweeted, "Playing Oliver Queen has been the greatest professional experience of my life, but you can't be a vigilante forever." He said, "Arrow will return for a final run of 10 episodes this fall. There's so much to say, but for now, I just want to say thank you." So the show's producers as well, Greg Berlanti and Mark Guggenheim and Beth Schwartz, they released a joint statement acknowledging that it had been a hard decision, but with the best interests of Arrow in mind. And they said they're heartened by the fact that Arrow had birthed an entire universe of shows that will continue for many years to come. And that's very true. You know, they've made a very good point there that they have literally birthed this whole Arrowverse. You've got mm-hmm. Supergirl, there's going to be a Batgirl movie as well. Batgirl series that's coming up as well. So it's not like, you know, we're going to forget about Arrow and it's not here anymore. It did spawn out like all these other great shows. And you want a show like this to go out on a high, you know? You don't want a series to end where people are not really getting it and it's lost its way, like Lost. I mean, we all remember how much time we wasted on that one. So we want Arrow to go up. Exactly. So we want Arrow to go out on a high, short season, 10 episodes, and then it's done this fall.
But I have to ask, though, look, we just rounded up the Oscars, and if you notice, with regards to television awards, talking about the Emmys, they have more dramatic roles. Kind of like how we used to stereotype the Oscars at some point until they changed. So do you think perhaps in the nearest future we might see that sort of dramatic change with the Emmys, where action, thrillers and, you know, superhero movies are also getting nominated for these kind of awards? Is there any possibility that in the nearest future a series like this could actually get something?
Absolutely, because these shows are coming up so much in quality. You know, they've got great script writers behind them, great showrunners behind them, and they've got such huge fan bases. And I think these fans, it's about time that their love for these shows were recognized. Of course, like you said, the BAFTA TV Awards and the Emmys are often known for being quite highbrow, things like Downton Abbey and Sherlock and things like that, always winning the awards. And those are great shows, don't get me wrong, and I love watching them. But I think you're right that it's time that shows like like these, things like the Arrowverse, like the Marvels, the DC Universes, all those kind of shows are recognized at these TV awards because, like I say, they have such a huge fan base. They do such great numbers with their viewership, and they spawn out all these different shows that keep actors working, that keep writers in jobs, and keep the fans occupied. And I think the Emmys should, and the BAFTA TV Awards, and all these kind of TV awards should recognize them. And I hope that will start from next year. Like you said, we saw it in the Oscars. So let's hope they take a lead from that.
Well, Afua, it's always a pleasure. Thank you so much. It's Afua Adom, our in-house entertainment correspondent, all the way from London. Afua, shout out my man them in North London, you get me.
Anyways, now, between this week's release of the highly anticipated Captain Marvel and then the forthcoming debut of Shazam, the comic book movie renaissance has shown no signs of slowing down. Now, producer James Gunn's Brightburn, which according to the latest trailer looks like a horrifying new take on the Superman origin story, well, it is set to dominate the industry, proving yet again his high comic intellect. Well, let's take a look at that trailer.
Who am I?
You are a gift.
We believe that you came here for a reason. I know it's been difficult for you lately, that you feel different from other kids.
Touch the floor, Brian!
You are different.
Caitlin, get my hand up.
He's a creep.
Help him up.
What are you doing?
I want him in handcuffs and I want him gone.
Do you even know who his real mother is?
I'm his real mother.
Let's go.
Maybe there is something wrong with Brandon.
I will never turn against our son.
He's not my son!
Hey, who's messing with me?
As always, that was an absolutely fantastic show, and I hope you guys agree too. Now, that's all from everyone in Lagos and in London. Thank you so much for watching the show. You can catch us every day, same time, same place. That's 4 p.m. right here on the Arise News channel. So until tomorrow, I'm Mercy Anjashafir.
And I'm Kachi Offia. This has been Arise 360. Goodbye.
You can.